Greetings again, adventurers, and welcome back to Let's Play Revelations Persona. In the last episode, we finally ventured into the Sebec building proper, and at the end of the last episode, we encountered what can only be described as SMTBS, in the form of Moshavos, otherwise known as Kimonos, with their terrifyingly crippling Binal Strike. Which is pretty devastating. We've also been encountering a few Sebec employees, many of whom are confused about the sudden happenings, both to the building and the town of Lunarvale. And we have also been fighting against various employee agents of Guido Sardinia as well, which is never a good thing. But we have most of it. Exploring to do on the third floor, and then I believe we only have two floors left to explore. But with the layout being completely messed around, this place is a veritable labyrinth, to say the least. And more nightmares to deal with. Fun, fun, fun. You know what? We'll get rid of you with a spell card, and you can all just run away and not leave me anything. Thank you for that. And away they go. And I believe we can actually, well, we've pretty much explored everywhere, I think. Yeah, that was, pretty much everywhere we could go, on the third floor. So, fourth floor it is. Hooray. And not the fifth floor. I think we're like, oh, there's a room behind us. I want to go there first. And of course, before we can get to that room, we have to fight demons. Well, not demons, more Secret Service agents. And I won't skip any battles because, well, not where the SS are concerned, because it's always fun to fight up against Sebec's, or in this case, Guido's agents. And I'll have Mark use his shotgun since he's passing skills as well. Why not? Shame that none of you are frozen. Ooh! And they don't pull their punches either. They actually will be annoying. To say the least. But we have the power of Persona on our side, so we can actually stand up to them. Go! And they support us with eyes and ears and voodoo. And
want some?
Magic abilities. And on second thought, Mark's shotgun is worse than useless against these guys, or against anything in general. They can actually, you know what, no, I don't want to talk to these guys, they don't negotiate anyway. I want Nate to actually hit somebody with Iron Punch. And I'm merry about it. Attacks.
Help me!
Now maybe if you're lucky, Mark, I'll have you defeat one of these guys with your trusty battle axe, and two of them are frozen. Now that's means they'll be easier to take out or deal with in this case.
Take it!
Powerful.
dead.
Behold the power of the mighty Jack. At our service. Yeah. They're useful enemies to fight against, giving us quite a bit of experience, and we're going to go into this room here to find out where we're going to go before we move anywhere else. And more rooms and creepy background ambient music. And there's the Sebec logo again. Company logo. Well, at least you're not saying kill this time, which I suppose is a slight improvement. They pretty much say the same dialogue that they said before. 10. A Delta Storm. Another shotgun shell. And another trapped container. Ooh, poison. That's bad. Fortunately, Mary can deal with that with the power of Maria. We can cure that poison. And, we can cure. We can actually, heal ourselves up. But, going back to our items, Mark, I'm gonna have to take away that shotgun shell, from you. Alright, I can use the M10, that's nice. And the Delta Storm is a bow, believe it or not. It is actually a very good bow. I don't know, but that can be somewhat useful, and more enemies. More Shippos, what a surprise. Shippos are resilient, but not too difficult to fight against, but it looks like Persona's leveled. Pawn is almost at level, is almost at rank 8. Voodoo is at rank 8, Shaman is yet to be rank 8, and Jack Frost is at rank 6, so eventually we'll be switching over to item 1 soon enough, and hopefully at some point we'll actually get alternative personas for Nate and Mark as well. Now we can actually move forward on the 4th floor and head to any of the other rooms here on this corridor. And some of these rooms might actually lead to dead ends, or some of these corridors in any case. And of course, bring the house down on these guys, and Holy White, which is Voodoo's ultimate attack, which will be fairly useful against large hordes of undead, or enemies that are incredibly susceptible to holy magic. The SS agents are not susceptible to holy magic in the slightest, but I'm sure it will do quite a bit of damage in hours. We always want to make sure that our personas reach rank 8 as much as possible. These guys don't play nice. They don't play well. Did fair enough damage. Of course, the SS don't really have any sort of elemental advantages, nor do they have disadvantages either. Which is kind of interesting. But, we can actually, increase the ranks of our designers and our abilities. And we're actually quickly getting to the point where we can actually start using some of our higher tier personas. Although it'll be some time before we actually reach the third.
Get him!
And I might want to consider healing Marg at some point, because I don't really want my party member's health to be under 100.
You wish!
Once again, Nate being left with absolutely nothing to do because the enemies are out of his range. And how courteous of you to move closer. Can't do anything, so magic. And Mary and Mark
will be
combo attack. By that I mean group attacks. There we go. And persona level. Fantastic. It's a bit of a waste of time, but here on this floor, which is surprising. Now they lead to a room down here. Could this be, I wonder? Another employee room. Why not? Why does it contain storage? Who the hell knows? And apparently a student from St. Hermelin has arrived here. Please don't tell me it was Alan. Oh, trust me, Mr. Employee, we're not here on a field trip. Indeed, they know nothing of Guido's grand plans, making them victims as well of his ambitions. We'll do that soon enough, Mark. Now, we have more items to find. Black shoes, which I'm sure will come in quite handy. A gift box. Don't know what it's used for, but who knows. We'll definitely be putting those shoes to good use. And I think, yeah, that's pretty much everything we can learn in this particular room. So, back upstairs we go. And once we've scoured this wall, we can finally head on down to the, or up, I should say, to the fifth floor. Head in this direction, and of course there'll be more enemies. Trio of Nightmares, no match for Nate's Holy Right abilities. And this was a dead end. Of course it was. Alrighty then, so there's the elevator, back this way. End. It's not marked on the map, but here you can see it's pretty much a dead end. And there is another corridor around, but we can't actually access it, and we just ran into a demon encounter. Because why not? Ooh, and some new enemies. We have Yakuzas, which is exactly what they are. And we also have cockatrices. These ones won't turn us to stone, as they do in Far Fantasy. But, actually going to get the cockatrices, and we can negotiate them with them by having Mark stare at them. Or maybe not. No, I was reading the wrong thing. Sorry. I screwed up. My mistake. Mary, you handle this. Something in exchange. $17. You can have it. And it's time for Nate to step in. No, I didn't want to do that. I didn't want to do that. Oh my god. No, it wasn't. It wasn't your fault. Oh god, I screwed up. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Please. Please let me have this. Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh man. And of course, magic stone. I was afraid that I'd screwed that up, but we got the spell card from the cockatrice. Ooh, and we got loads of spell cards. Oh, throw out the zombie boy. Don't really need it at this point. There we go. Yeah, really need to get all the spell cards, so hopefully we run into those Yakuza again at some point. In any event, go to the elevator and go to floor 5. To the 5th floor we go. Hooray, huzzah. And this corridor seems, I was going to say somewhat straightforward, but it starts branching out in various paths and just branches out into a dead end. Because of course it does. And we've run into some new demons here. We have the Nue, or Nuea. We also have the Devshif, otherwise known as a Nizrock. And we also have the Hanya, which is sometimes, which doesn't actually refer to our unfortunate vice principal, despite the very similar names. Now, which one to actually... I think I'm gonna go for the Devshif. In terms of contact, because, it's not often that we actually get to, negotiate with these enemies. You find them in these particular configurations, but they are often hard to come across. Seems like my persuasion is doing pretty good. And he's intrigued enough to hopefully give me his spell card. throw out the Zombie Girl spell card. There we go. I need to find a velvet room at some point to deal with all these damn cards. I think we actually have a much better chance of running into the Hanyas and Nueyas than we do the Dev Chefs. They can actually be pretty annoying to sort of locate. And it doesn't seem that there are any particular rooms on this floor, but there is a staircase up here. Yeah, there wasn't really anywhere else we can go to on this floor. But, yeah, this place is quite the proverbial labyrinth. Even more so than the other areas. We need to actually, have I gone the right way? There's a room up here, which probably signifies that I haven't. Which is very annoying. And more angels, so one moment. Alright, those are taken care of, so now we can go into this room here. And it appears to be another Sebec quarters. And there's that kill again, and you're just gonna say the exact same thing as you did before. M500. Two more Kevlar vests. Fantastic. Another shotgun shell. And another trink, which will be put into good use. Mark, you can finally have a Kevlar vest. But you won't get a trink. I'm afraid, because we're one short. Now we don't have any other headgear. M500. Oh, you can use it, but it is completely useless. Because why not? Yeah, we'll really need to find a velvet room. Of course, we need to find an alternate set of stairs on the fifth floor. Oh, sorry about that, adventurers. Finally run into those Yakuza. Could fight them, but I'm going to negotiate with them, because why not? And now it's time for Mark to stare at them from head to toe. Or glare at them in this instance. This way? Goddammit. We screwed up. That is unfortunate. Unfortunate indeed. I'll need to negotiate with them later at some point. And, unfortunately now it's not going to work. And I say boo to that. As I say boo to everything, let a single spell card slip by. You need to do that in this Let's Play adventure. The Yakuza's, despite all their bluster, aren't that tough. They've all got katanas, but we have the swords. So that pretty much evens the odds, in my opinion. That was a shame that I got negotiation went so poorly. But what can you do? Oh, wow. And we got a shock sword out of that, and believe it or not, I think Nate can actually use that as a weapon at long last. Finally, get rid of that darn scalpel. There we go. Now you can finally do some melee damage. Back up we go to the, up to the physical, I said. Not that way. Behind the other set of stairs which leads down, because we that way's a dead end. No, another back attack. Oh, by these three again. Interesting that you'd use that on Nate of all people. Oh god. This time we can negotiate with the Hanya. This time. And believe it or not, in order to negotiate with this demon, Nate needs to yell at it. Oh, this is, that might or not have, gone my favor. Or maybe it did. Please. Thank you. Okay. Now we're in business. That actually worked. Sometimes it doesn't. Demons can be fairly unpredictable at the best of times. And, I might throw out the imp. The knocker spell card. Probably a bad idea, but oh well. Shame I couldn't use it, to create a persona, but, well, that's just how it is. This way we need to go. Yeah, it is. And of course we're attacked by yet more demons. More angels. And we got a magic stone from them. Marvelous. Always want more magic stones to battle the demons, but this way is the way that we go to get out of here. Oh, and look, more Nues. It's a good thing I got those first two personas then, and I should probably mark them off the list. Let's see, Hanya and Digitiv. Means I don't have to go for them later, and to that I say, hell yes. So my choices paid off, and I have merry waste time. Oh, and they want life energy. Oh wow, that actually increased their interest, which is good. So, Mary can keep negotiating. Oh, and I'm gonna have to switch over to Nate. Bribe them with your special gifts. And life energy as well. There we go. We'll have to throw out another spell card, but I'm gonna throw out the zombie. Because why not? Sorry, zombie cop. I'm not being made into a persona. Very well. As soon as we find a velvet room, we can actually do this. And hopefully now actually found our way to the stairs leading down. And there's a room over here that we can go into. That just so happens to be a velvet room. Thank you. Welcome again, Igor. This episode is getting pretty long, so I'm going to leave it here for the time being. And when we return, adventurers, we shall finally... We'll head back into the velvet room and finally start fusing those spell cards into some new personas. As always, adventurers, until next we meet.